Well, America's students need some help, apparently, with a history lesson. A new report out shows this week that only 20% of fourth graders, 17% of eighth graders, and 12% of high school seniors are proficient in history. So why do our students continue to lag behind? Joining me now is the founder of Teach for America and the author of A Chance to Make History, Wendy Kopp. Great to see you, Wendy.
Good to see you.
So Americans see those startling results and they think, oh my goodness, you know, we're supposed to be the most powerful country in the world, and yet our kids don't know history. Why?
You know, what we see every day in our work, and you know, we work in the most, you know, under-resourced communities in our country, and we just see daily evidence that when kids are met with high expectations and the supports they need to, you know, excel, they do excel, and they excel according to the highest standards. So
what you're actually saying then, if I'm reading you correctly, is that sometimes it doesn't have to do so much with the resources as it does with a great teacher in the classroom.
It's about great teachers. It's about, I think, you know, conceptualizing maybe the mission of our schools differently than we have historically. I think, you know, historically we look at schools as institutions that put learning opportunities in front of kids, and we assume that some kids will really get it and some will sort of get it and some will maybe not so much get it. Mm-hmm. And I think what we've seen is that when we can create schools with a mission of ensuring that all of their kids accomplish, you know, achieve academically, gain the character strength as well that they need to have a full range of educational and professional options, then great things happen. There's a greater sense of purpose to everything that goes on in the school.
There's been so much talk in the last couple of years about the union's relationship with schools. Michelle Rhee was the chancellor of schools in D.C. She did a lot of nouveau types of techniques there, and she eventually left that job and has started other missions. But where do you fall on the idea of the unions, and Waiting for Superman, the documentary also highlighted this, the union sort of being the problem in our school systems?
You know, I mean, I think what Michelle is and many others are most focused on is the fact that in our country, which aspires to be a land of equal opportunity, where kids are born still determines their educational prospects and in turn life prospects. It's a massive problem. You know, 15 million kids in our country growing up below the poverty line, half of them will not even graduate from high school, and the half who do have an eighth grade skill level compared to kids in high income communities. Mm-hmm. 8% of our low-income kids graduate from college. So that's the tragedy. And I think what many folks in the last few years and what Waiting for Superman and others have brought to the fore is just evidence that it does not have to be that way. Mm-hmm. We now know, I mean, when we first got into this 20 years ago, that seemed like a big, entrenched, impossible-to-move situation. Mm. Today, we have evidence everywhere that we can change things.
And one of the ways you're doing that is Teach for America has fellows, gives young kids the opportunity to go and become teachers. And my goodness, they're highly coveted positions. The application rate is, you only accept 11%, right?
Well, what we're working to do is to marshal the energy of our country's future leaders against this problem of educational inequity. You know, initially by getting them to commit 2 years to teach in urban and rural public schools, but then to go on and exert leadership for a lifetime to affect fundamental change in the way things are. So yeah, this year we had 50,000 people apply to Teach for America. We're bringing about more than 5,000 of them into teaching. We'll have 9,000 Teach for America.
So it's an amazing program, and you are the founder of Teach for America.
Yeah.
Wendy Kopp, thank you so much for being here
today. Thank you.